Hello and welcome to part 3 of the second of the 3 weekly lessons about Oracle Jet. Let's continue from part 2 where you learned about the Oracle Jet data visualization components. In this part you'll be introduced to the Oracle Jet components that help you to render data collections in various ways. There are a range of components in this category. Here we will focus on two that you are most likely to use, which are the table component and the tree component. Let's start by taking a look at the table component. Go to the cookbook, go to the table recipe, notice the most basic table in the recipe, remove some of the data in there to make it as simple and as short and as focused as possible, and then copy and paste the relevant code from the JavaScript side where the data is found and from the HTML side. Normally it's best to start on the HTML side and paste it in so that you have the view there and you can see which parts of the JavaScript from the recipe you actually need to copy. Here you can see that we have reference to something called a data source, which is defined in the JavaScript side. That is all we need to copy from the JavaScript recipe. Paste that into our view model. And take note that here is defined our data source that is referenced on the HTML side. This is a read-only property. And also take note of a very useful utility class from Oracle Jet, which will convert our array into a table data source. Jet provides a number of these utility classes for converting data from one format into another format. Include the reference to the component, go back to the browser, and notice that you now have a table. In the same way, we're going to now take a look at the tree view component. In the cookbook, find the tree view recipe. Explore on the left-hand side all the different variations on the basic tree view. The most simple one has its data hard-coded into the view. More likely, what you want to do is access data via a REST endpoint and then process it via JSON. There is an example in the cookbook that shows you how to work with JSON. The JSON is hard-coded. At the end here, you see that a JSON tree data source utility class is used, which is comparable to the table data source that we made use of in the previous example. The JSON tree data source takes JSON and converts it and handles it for us so that we don't have to do the JSON parsing ourselves. Back in the cookbook, copy the references to the Oracle Jet components that you're making use of from the cookbook into the define block in your view model as always. And then go into the view in the cookbook and copy the OJ tree view as well as the script below it. Paste it into the view. This is the standard process for moving components from the cookbook into your applications. Notice in particular how items in the tree are rendered by an extension of functionality that Knockout makes available. Also notice the read-only property called data that is mapped to the data property of the tree view. Back in the browser, notice we have now a tree view displayed with data provided via JSON in our view model.
Other data collection components to be aware of are the data grid, the list view, row expander, paging control, and indexer. It's often a bit confusing when having to choose between using a simple table component or a more advanced data grid component. To help with this decision, the Jet Developer's Guide provides a table of differences between these two components. In this part, you have been introduced to the data collection components with a focus on the table and the tree. You've learned the data collection components have a basic set of features as well as a wide range of options that you can use to customize them. Each component has events which let you connect the HTML view to the business logic and JavaScript. The cookbook provides complete recipes for each component as well as a link to the related JavaScript documentation. In the next part, you'll learn how to connect data sources to Jet components that you have learned about so far. For your homework for this part, take another look at the table and at the tree, as well as at the grid component. Copy one or two of them from the cookbook into an Oracle Jet application and try and configure them to fit your specific business requirements. Review the different demo pages in the cookbook again for different examples of how these components can be used. With that, we'll wrap up the third part of the second week of the course in Oracle Jet, and we'll see you again in the next part.